an indefinable, mysterious power that pervades everything. I feel it, though I do not see it. It is this unseen power which makes itself felt and yet defies all rule, because it is so unlike all that I perceive through my senses. It transcends the senses, but it is possible to reason out the existence of God to a limited extent. Even in ordinary affairs, we know that people do not know who rules or why and how he rules. And yet, they know that there is a power that certainly rules. In my tour last year in Mysore, I met many poor villagers, and I found upon inquiry that they did not know who ruled Mysore. They simply said some god ruled it. If the knowledge of these poor people was so limited about their blood, I, who am infinitely lesser in respect to God than they to their ruler, need not be surprised if I do not realize the presence of God, the King of Kings. Nevertheless, I do feel, as the poor villagers said about my soul, that there is orderliness in the universe. There is an unalterable law governing everything and every being that exists or thinks. It is not a blind law, for no blind law can govern the conduct of human beings. And thanks to the marvelous researches of the Nancy Group, it can now be proved that even matter is blind. That law, then, which governs all life, is God. Law and the lawgiver are one. I may not deny the law or the lawgiver because I know so little about God or him. Just as my denial or ignorance of the existence of an earthly power will avail me nothing, even so, my denial of God and the law will not liberate me from its operation. Whereas humble and mute acceptance of earthly rule makes life a bit easier. I do dimly perceive that while everything around me is ever changing, ever dying, there is underlying all that change a living power that is changing all to better, that creates, dissolves, and recreates. That informing power or spirit is God.